continue now at the top of Daf Tzadi Ches Amar Aleph Meseches Shabbos. This is Shabbos Daf 98a. The Gemara here is in the middle of discussing a brisa which talks about throwing from one Rishus HaRabim to another Rishus HaRabim through Rishus HaYachid. And the brisa until this point said that if it travels four Amos in Rishus HaRabim, even if a little bit of that four Amos was in the first Rishus HaRabim, and then it finished the four Amos in the other Rishus HaRabim, they could be mitzdarif and yirchayiv for throwing four Amos in Rishus HaRabim. And the brisa continues, Pachas me'arav amos pater. But if it doesn't travel four amos in Rosh Hashanah, then you're pater. Rashi here says, Pachas me'arav amos pater, d'mishum hotzol lo mechayiv. You're not chayiv for taking from Rosh Hashanah to Rosh Hashanah, or from Rosh Hashanah to Rosh Hashanah. The law amin includes the kamash shunch. We don't say that when it traveled through the Rosh Hashanah, it's as if it came to rest in Rosh Hashanah. So the transporting from Rosh Hashanah to Rosh Hashanah is irrelevant. And in terms of arba amos, it didn't, in this case, it didn't go four amos in Rosh Hashanah, even when we were mitzdarif the Turishas Rabbims, so you are potter. So the Gemara now says, my Kamashmalon, what is this teaching us? Ha Kamashmalon, it teaches us Rishuyos Mitzdarfos. Number one, Rishuyos can join together. As we saw, one Rishas Rabbim can join with the other to count towards your four Amos and Rishas Rabbim. When the law amrin and Kluta Kamashoncha, we don't say the rule of Kluta Kamashoncha. Rashi here explains, Rishuyos Hashavos Mitzdarfos. Similar Rishuyos can be mitzdarif. Rishus HaRabim Zu im Rishus HaRabim Zu. This Rishus HaRabim can be mitzdarif with this Rishus HaRabim. Udalo k'Rabbi Yossi, this does not follow the opinion of Rabbi Yossi. Da'amar pe'perek ha'motzi yayin, he says in perek ha'motzi yayin, af behelim echod l'rishus echod chayiv l'shtei rishuyos pater. It's talking about over there, you take out a half a shear to one Rishus and a half a shear to another Rishus. He says you're not mitzdarif the two Rishuyos and you say pater. If it's to one Rishus, you can be mitzdarif. So this does not go like Rabbi Yossi, because here we're saying you are mitzdarif Rishuyos. V'yod kamash malon de lo amin and kluta kamash hancha. It further teaches us that we do not say kluta kamash hancha. The Gemara continues at the two dots. Amar Rav Shmuel bar Yehuda, Amar Rav Abba, Amar Rav Huna, Amar Rav. Rav Shmuel bar Yehuda says in the name of Rav Abba, in the name of Rav Huna, in the name of Rav. Hamavir dalid amos b'rishus haravim mikora pater. If somebody transports something for amos, carries something for amos in rishus haravim that has a roof over it, he's going to be pater in that case. Rashi says mikora is mechusa, means covered up. So the Gemara says, Lefisha eino dom miladigle midbar, because it is not comparable to the way they carried in the midbar, so it didn't have a roof in that case, therefore you are putter in this scenario. So the Gemara asks, Ini, is that really so? V'ha agolos de mekoros havin, weren't the wagons, they were covered up, and it was considered a Rishus HaRabim, so therefore it is in fact similar to the digle midbar. Rashi here explains, V'ha agolos de mishkon de mekoros havu. Bekrushim. What happened was the agolos, you had wagons and you put the beams on the wagons. Bekrushim hasturim aleim, and you laid the krushim across the wagons. Rochvon laorech agola. You put their width according to the length of the agola. Veorchon lerochvon, and their length went according to the width. So imagine you took these long beams and you laid them along the width of the wagons. Arosh Daphno said they went on top of the walls of the wagon. The kasalka daitach. Right now we think that they arranged the beams along the entire length of the wagon. So there was just beam after beam, all kind of piled up one after the other. So that's how the agolos were arranged. The Omar Rav Mishum Rabbi Chia, and Rav said in the name of Rabbi Chia, agolos, when it came to the wagons, tachtehen uveinehen vitzidehen Rishas HaRabim. Beneath them, between them, and at their sides was all considered Rishas HaRabim. And the point here is that there was covered areas, there was roofed areas, and we're still considering it Rishus HaRabim. Rashi here explains, Uveinein bein agola la'agola shebetzida. We're talking about between one wagon and the wagon next to it. V'ava b'sharoshe hakroshim yotzim l'kan u'l'kan. Even though the top of the beams stuck out from the wagon in both directions, shtei amos u'mechza l'chol ruach. It stuck out 2.5 amos in each direction. V'roshe kroshim shel agola zu magin l'roshe kroshim shel zu. And the ends of one beam from one wagon would actually basically touch the beams of the other wagon. They were right next to each other. Shabbatzita, the one that was right next to it. Sharei chomesh amos hayu bein agola agola. There were 5 amos of space between the wagons. V'rochav agola chomesh amos. And also the wagon itself was 5 wide. Hacholo shtei amos umechso. The empty space in the wagon, there was like, you picture some wheels on the ground with kind of hollow walls around them. And then you had 2 amos hollow there, 2.5 amos, shtei amos umechza, ubein hadefanos v'ofanim, v'ovei ofanim, and if you count up all the space of the walls and the thickness of the wheels, shtei amos umechza, that would be another 2.5. So the entire thickness of the wagon was 2.5. The Yud Amos Orech HaKoresh, and the actual length of the beams were 10 Amos. U'kishorcha Noson al Dofne Agolim, when you put the length along the walls of the wagons, L'rachva to the width, Nimtzu Beis Amos Umechza Bolton, Mikol Tzad. So you'd essentially have 5 Amos, the middle part of the beams were on top of the wagon, and then 2.5 Amos sticking out of each side. V'nimtzu Revach Shebein Beis HaGolos Mekora B'rashay Krashim. And it came out that the space between the two wagons was covered, it was roofed. V'tzideyan, that's Revach Shebein Dofen Agolo Lo'ofen V'ovei Ofen. The sides refers to the space between the wall of the Agola and the wheel and the thickness of the wheel. There was a little space over there. There was some empty space. So in any case, the point is, don't we see from the way they carried in the Mishkan that it was covered, and those areas were considered Rishus Rabim, as Reb Chiya says. Rav says in the name of Reb Chiya, Agolas Tachteinu V'Neimet Zidane, Rishus Rabim. So the Gemara answers, Kikah Marav, when did Rav say that underneath the wagons is a Rishus Rabim? Bidrasa. Rashi explains what that means. Bidrasa berevach shebein shuros haseder sheyasod keresh al keresh seder echad. What he would do is he'd pile up a bunch of beams in one row. Umeinicho revach, and there'd be a little space for soder seder echad. There'd be another pile of beams. Umeinicho revach. So he meant in the space, in the airspace where there was no covering, that was considered rishus harabim. But of course, areas that were covered would not be considered rishus harabim. So the Gemara says, Michti, let us see. If we're talking about the space between the beams, how much space is there between each pile of beams? What was the length of each wagon? Chamesh amin, it was 5 amos. Posyod kerish kamahavai, what was the width of each beam? Am sopalga, it was 1.5 amos. So kama mosif, so how many beams could you put on the wagon if each one is 1.5 wide and the whole thing is 5 amos wide? It's lossy, you can only put 3, and that total is going to add up to 4.5 amos of beam on top of the wagon. Poshale palga da amsa, your total empty space is only 0.5 amos. So kishadi le mar beini ubeini. Now, when you take that half amma of empty space and put it between each pile of beams, kilava dummy, it's going to be loved. You're going to have less than 3 tvachim between each pile. So there is no empty space at all, because halachically, anything that's within 3 tvachim of each other is as if it's sealed halachically. It's like it's all closed up. So the Gemara says, misavir krashim apusayu have manachlu. Do you think that they laid the beams down on their width? Achudan manachlu. They laid them on their thickness. So the Gemara says, well, let's do the math over there. Sof, sumcha de keresh kamav. What was the thickness of each beam? Amsa was 1 amma. So kamav and mosa, how many beams could you get on the wagon? Arba, you can get four beams on the wagon, taking up 4 amos. Pashala amsa, and you have 1 amma left over, because again, the wagon was 5 amos long. So kishadi lomar beini ubeini. So again, when you put a separation, an even separation between each pile, kalavadami, it's going to be much less than 3 tvachim of space between each pile. And again, you're going to have love it. There's going to be no empty space. So the Gemara says, Hanicho l'man do'amar kroshim milmatan ovyon amma milmalon kolin v'holchen ad ka'etzba. This actually will work out according to the opinion that the beams on the bottom, they were an amma thick, but they actually got sharp to a point. They thinned out. So then you're going to have a lot of space shopper. Then it all works out well, because there's going to be a lot of empty space where the beams narrow. So now they're not really so close to each other anymore. They come to a sharp point at the top. There's no problem. El lamando amar kashem shemil matan ovyan amma kach milmalo ovyan amma. But according to the opinion that the beams were an amma thick all the way from top to bottom, ma'ikolamemar, again, there's really no space between the beams. So Amar Rav Kahana says, ba'atbi, we're talking about the rings. So what does that mean? Rashi here explains, ba'atbi, berevach shebein sideh hakroshim shahatabos kvuos bohem ka'amar rav, tehavi rishus harabim. Kilomar, what it means is as follows. The beams had rings on them. And there would be these poles that went through the rings. So there were rings sticking out of the beams. And Rashi explains, Kolomar, Yevshel Asader Bo Arba Storim Kedekamer. It's impossible that there were 4 rows evenly spread out amongst the wagon, as you said. Lefisha Tabos Kavun Bekrashim, because there are rings sticking out of there. You can't put one right next to the other. Kedeksiv, like it says, Bas Tabosem Tasa Zav Sheatochiv Habrichim Lesochan. Lefisha Ngvos, because Yosh Vazal Adorim Shenim Ala Ama, Menanus Lefnim Ala Achor. Ela Shabrichim Mechabrim Es Kulam. He's just explaining how the poles helped to solidify and make it sturdy when the Mishkan was standing. You couldn't put the beams next to each other because the rings would crash into each other. Essentially, what you would do is you would put 2 piles of beams back to back, so the rings were sticking out to the outside, and then on the other side, on the full other side of the wagon, you do the other 2 back to back. So there would actually be a large space the full arm of space between them. That's what Rashi's trying to say. That tzara tabos shel chitzon lechutz v'shel panimis lefnim. The ring on the outer one would point outward, and the ring on the inner board would point inward. Vein tzarech laniach revich b'nim. There was no space between those two piles of beams. V'chein barosh ha'gola hasheni. Then the other side did the same thing. The cholachas harevich b'emza bein tzidei hatabos kach pirshu rabosai v'kach ha'yugorsin. Fine. So that's the pshat that Rashi here gives in the name of his rebbeim, that it was again they were piled up two right next to each other, flush against each other, and then two on the other side of the wagon right next to each other, flush against each other, and there was in fact enough space between that it was bigger. It was a full arm of space in between, so it was bigger than Lavan, and you'd actually have space. But then the Gemara says, but still, hey chamanachlu, where were they putting all these beams? Agav v'dagola, weren't they putting it on top of the wagon? Agola gufa mekora havoi, wasn't the wagon itself? Did the wagon itself have a roof? Are they putting it over empty space? And we'll see the Gemara's answer on Daf Tzadi Chesam and Beis in the next video, that indeed there was empty space on the top of the wagon.